Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. I am Dr. Muhibbullah Wazir, and the topic is the intersegmental division of the bronchi and the blood supply of the lungs. I told you that the trachea divided into right and left principal bronchus. Each principal bronchus divides into lobar or secondary bronchi, and each lobar bronchus then divides into segmental bronchi or tertiary bronchi, which is being surrounded by the segment of the lung. Now inside this segment, then the tertiary bronchus divides repeatedly into many divisions, and this you can see, look, this is the segmental bronchus, which divides and redivides, and ultimately this smaller segmental bronchus, which divides and redivides, and ultimately you can see these bronchioles are being formed. And the bronchiole is being characterized by the fact that the bronchiole do not have the cartilage. And then the bronchiole divides and redivides and form the terminal bronchioles, and the terminal bronchiole then divides into respiratory bronchioles, and over here you can see some of the alveoli or sacs where exchange of gas can occur into respiratory bronchioles as well. And then ultimately these respiratory bronchioles lead into this big alveolar sac, like this, alveolar sacs or alveoli or acinus. And over here there are alveoli lined by squamous epithelium, and this epithelium over here is of two types, that is squamous type 1, which is being lining 90% of the each alveolus, and that is being over here gas exchange occurs, while the rest 10% consists of the squamous epithelium type 2, which produce the surfactant effect over here, and also some macrophages migratory type are being present over here. So this is the intersegmental divisions, that is the tertiary bronchi, larger one and smaller one, and then bronchioles and pterobronchioles, and then respiratory bronchi, and ultimately the alveoli. This is the division of the bronchi inside the segment, and the gas exchange occurs at this alveolar level, and some exchange also occurs at this respiratory bronchiolar level as well. Now, what is the blood supply of lungs? The lung is being supplied by bronchial arteries and the pulmonary arteries. Note the point, it is dual blood supply. The bronchial arteries, which brings oxygenated blood, and the pulmonary arteries, which bring deoxygenated blood from the heart to the lungs. Note, the bronchial arteries, look over here please. This is the arch of the aorta, and this is the descending thoracic aorta. Look, from the aorta originates on the left side two arteries, that is superior bronchial artery left, inferior bronchial left artery. Two bronchial arteries on the left side originate from the aorta directly, while on the right side the bronchial artery originate from the right third posterior intercostal artery. This is the right third posterior intercostal artery, and this is the right bronchial artery. In this way, three bronchial arteries, it enters into the lung through the hilum. And note the point that this bronchial arteries, it supplies, it follows the bronchial tree and supplies the bronchi, the segmental bronchi, and then the bronchioles, and then the terminal bronchioles, and up to respiratory bronchioles. Beyond that, The alveoli and the alveolar sacs, these are being supplied by the pulmonary arteries up to respiratory bronchioles. It is being supplied by the bronchial arteries, which gives oxygenated blood as well as nutrients to these bronchi and the lung tissue. And then the veins which comes from these bronchi back, it falls into two systems. The superficial bronchial veins, which drains from the hilum and from the visceral pleura of the lung as well, it drains into the azygos vein on the right side and hemiazygos vein on the left side. While the veins which are drained from the deep tissue of the lung, that deep group of veins, this deep group of veins comes out of the hilum and it enters into the pulmonary veins or directly into the atrium. And in this way, the bronchial veins which drains the lung tissue, it some the superficial system of veins drains into azygos and hemiazygos, while the deep veins drains into the pulmonary veins or into the atrium. In this way, mixing this deoxygenated blood with the oxygenated blood which is present in the pulmonary veins. Note this point. Okay, this bronchial vein brings the deoxygenated blood from the lung tissue, while the pulmonary veins take oxygenated blood from the lungs to the heart. That's why these bronchial veins mix deoxygenated blood with the oxygenated blood of the pulmonary veins. Okay. While you look at the alveoli, look, this alveoli, take one, this alveolus. Look, it is having a rich capillary plexus in it. What happens that these pulmonary arteries that bring deoxygenated blood from the lung, it is full of nutrition but having less oxygen or no oxygen. What it follows the bronchial tree and ultimately reaches to the alveoli. When reaching into the alveoli, this pulmonary artery divides into capillaries and surrounds the alveolus. And you know, the alveolus is full of oxygenated air coming from the trachea to the alveolus. Oxygenated air. So this alveolus is full of oxygenated air, while this pulmonary artery is full of nutrition but having no oxygen. What happens that the alveolus gives oxygen to the pulmonary artery, while the pulmonary artery gives all nutrients to the alveolus. Exchange occurs over here, and then this blood then comes from this alveolus. Now it is full of oxygen and comes back through this pulmonary veins to the heart again. But note the point that the pulmonary arteries follows the bronchial tree, but the pulmonary veins do not follow the bronchial tree, but these veins lies in the this is one segment, and this lies in the intersegmental area. This pulmonary veins, it runs in the intersegmental area. And that's why one of the indication in the intersegmental area is the pulmonary vein as well, which separate the two segments from one another. Okay, this is the blood supply. The bronchial tree up to respiratory bronchial is supplied by bronchial arteries, while the alveoli are supplied by pulmonary arteries. Okay, the alveoli are drained by the pulmonary veins, which open into the left atrium, taking oxygenated blood, while the bronchial tree is being drained by the bronchial veins, which some of the superficial veins open into the azygos system, while the deep veins passes directly into the atrium or into the pulmonary veins. That's why mixing oxygenated and deoxygenated blood. Okay, this is about the blood supply of the lung. Thank you very much.